In this video, we're going to rig our 2D character in Unity, setting up sprites for rigging, adding bones, and preparing the character for animation. This is the second part of our four-part series, where we build a 2D side-scroller character template from drawing to final movement. If you haven't watched the first video where we drew and imported this character, I highly recommend starting there. It will help you follow along better. Alright. To start rigging a character, we should import the 2D animation package. You go to Window, Package Manager, head over to Unity Registry, and then make sure that 2D animation is installed. Because I have created this project with a 2D URP template, it is automatically installed. Next, we need to make sure to have a character, which is going to be a .psd file or a .psb file, and making sure that all of our arms and limbs and whatever is separated into its own individual layers. If you want to learn how I made this character, check out this video in the top right. You can also download this PSD file from the link in the description. So here is the character that I've made in Photopia. And here you can see the layers. I have created separate layers for the head, the right arm, the right leg, the torso, the left arm, and the left leg. As you can see here. Okay, that is the whole thing. You can separate the right arm into upper right arm and lower right arm. That's completely your choice. If you're putting them both in the same layer, that way they stay connected when you are animating. The other way gives you a lot more flexible control. Neither approach is wrong, so feel free to have fun with this. Again, you can check out the video where I made this. The link will be in the description. Also, you need to make sure that the 2D PSD importer is also imported so that we can import the .psd file. And we need to change the importer on the top right from texture importer to PSD importer. This allows us to access the layers, and each layer can have its own sprite, and Unity will create a mesh out of each sprite, and then we can create a rig and use that rig to animate the sprite, which is what we'll do in this video. So to begin with, select the PSD file, go to settings, and make sure that the texture type is sprite. Sprite mode is multiple. This should be there by default. Then open the sprite editor. If your sprite is not adjusted properly, make sure that each sprite is big enough to include the entire mesh. You can do that by dragging these things. I'm going to hit undo. Once you're in the sprite editor, we need to click on this and go to the skinning editor. If you have any changes, I'm going to revert it. Now you're in the skinning editor. Right off the bat, I recommend toggling this visibility icon. This is going to give you information about all of the different bones in the sprite. And let's start creating bones. So we need to click on create bone to create a bone. This is me speaking from my experience. We need to create a bone like this. Even though that looks kind of inappropriate, we need to click on this. We should rename this to something called root or hip. I think hip is fine. This is going to be the hip bone, and every other bone is going to be parented to this bone. This is me teaching from my experience. You should have a hip bone. Okay. Next, if you hover over it, you can see that we can create the next bone. It is of a different color. And it is linked to this bone, which means it's sort of like it's parented, which is why you need a root bone. So I'm going to create one. I'm going to create one like this and one like this. And then let's create a head bone as well. There we go. I'm going to right click to move it away. I can select these things and then adjust it to my will. Next, let's create our arms and legs. So we need to make sure that we are parented to this bone. So we need to select the middle bone, and I will create one bone, create arms like this, then right click. The same goes for the other arm. There we go. Right click. And this one is going to be parented not to the hip, but to the yellow one. We'll rename everything else later. There we go. And finally, there we go. We have created most of our bones. The final one is for the eyes. The eyes are going to have a separate bone. So click on the head and just create one like this. There we go. Now you can select this and then and then move it a little bit to the back. And we have all of the bones. Now, the next process is to make sure that all of the bones are named appropriately. This one is going to be the hip. This is going to be the spine. This is going to be, torso. There are no rules to this, so you can have your own fun with this. I'm going to edit this so that it matches the other one. This is going to be upper arm left. This is going to be lower arm left. This one, upper arm right. This one, lower arm right. This one is going to be the head. This one is going to be eyes. Upper leg right. Lower leg right. And I'm going to adjust this. Upper leg left. Lower leg left. There we go. Now all of the bones are named appropriately. And if you do want to split a bone, you can click on split bone and it will split this bone into two if you want. So there's that as well. Once you're done, the next step is to add weights. So you click on edit bone. If you double click on the sprite here, it is going to select that sprite. And you can see the mesh and the polygons that it has created. Okay, this is the shape of the mesh. What do we do next? Make sure to select the bone. Make sure that a sprite is selected. And click auto weights. Now this is going to create something that is very weird. And now we can go to individual bones. Now select the one mesh. And then click on weight brush. We can increase the size of the brush here. And increase the step to something like, let's say, 75. Make sure that the mode is add and subtract. And now if you hover over each vertex of the mesh, paint over these mesh. Aha! Now all of these vertices are affected by this bone. And the green one is not affecting anything. So let's click on the green one. And now if you paint over this, now you can see that the top part of the sprite can now be affected by this bone. What do I mean by this? If you go to preview pose, now that we have done the rigging, aha! Now the mesh is also rotating along with the bones. So this is how we do rigging. We can click on restore pose. Now go back to weight brush, double click on the next mesh, select the bone, and just paint over the vertices that you want selected. Select the next bone, paint over the vertices that you want. Cool. Now you can see everything is painted properly. Select the mesh, paint over it, select the bone, and start painting over it. There we go. Let me select the head bone, and now I can just paint all of the vertices. Now I can select the eyes, make sure that the eye bone is selected, and then just paint, and eyes are also parented. Let's select the leg, make sure to select the upper bone and paint it, then the lower bone, and then paint it. Just for testing, you can rotate and see if there are any errors. And I can see that this is not being painted. And that is because this top bone has influence over that particular vertex. And once you start painting enough, you can see that the errors are gone. You can also select each sprite and then auto weight and click on associate bones and hit generate. Cool. This is going to give you auto weighting. And then you can just test it out by moving all of these things, making sure that the entire thing feels good. Now our rigging is complete. Okay, now this is the final geometry. I'm going to hit apply at the top to save the changes. Now we are ready to animate this character. And all you got to do is go to the character and then drag and drop them into the scene. So I recommend simply creating an empty game object, calling it Stickman or something. Make sure to reset the transform. Also reset the transform for this. Stickman is at the feet. You can move this so that it is right at the feet. And then parent Stickman to the Stickman here. Now go back to the 2D character, create a prefab of the Stickman. So now we have a prefab which we can export. And there we go. We have all of our bones. Now if you go to one of these bones and let's say we move it, you can see that the eyes are moving. If you go to the head, you can see the head is also moving, which is great. Now our character has a full skeletal rig setup and it's ready to move. In the next video, we'll add animations. We'll create a basic idle and run animation using Unity's 2D animation system. And remember, we are slowly building towards a reusable character controller template. So stay with me and I'll walk you through every step. See you in part 3. Take care. I love you.